हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू कामत एस्ट्रोलॉजी। एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर वन मोर टॉपिक, दैट इज अंडरस्टैंडिंग द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द भवा चार्ट एंड राशि चार्ट। सो वन ऑफ आवर व्यूअर्स हैड आस्क्ड मी वेदर देर इज एनी डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ भवा एंड अ राशि, एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी वॉट एग्जैक्टली इज द डिफरेंस। सो इन दिस video I will also explain how we can derive the bhava chart from the rashi chart using a method called bhav madhya। Om Sri Ganeshaya Namaha। Now look at this diagram carefully, okay? This actually shows the rashi chart of a person born in the Sima Lagna, okay? The Lagna or the ascendant is at 29 degrees in the Sima Lagna or the sign of Leo. So Leo is the first Rashi, second Rashi is Virgo, third Rashi is Tula, fourth Rashi is Scorpio, and so on. Okay, the 12th Rashi is Karka Rashi. So this is the Rashi chart which is shown in black. So the Rashi chart has the 12 Rashis numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, with the first Rashi starting from the sign of Leo or Sima. Okay. Now from this, how do we derive the Bhava chart? So to derive the Bhava chart, there are many methods, okay, but in this video, we will use a method called as Bhav Madhya. So look at the degree of the ascendant or the Lagna. The degree of the ascendant, as can be seen in the square labeled number 1, is 29 degrees. Okay, so this is called as the Bhav Madhya. So 29 degrees in the sign of Leo is the center of the first Bhava. Okay, now every Bhava is 30 degrees in this method. So from the ascendant 29 degrees, count 15 degrees backward and count 15 degrees forward. Okay. So you will see that the first Bhava starts at 14 degrees in the sign of Leo or Sima, okay, and it ends at 14 degrees in the sign of Virgo or Kanya. So I have shown this first Bhava with brown font and brackets. Similarly, where the first Bhava starts, you count 15 degrees backward, you reach the Bhav Madhya of the 12th Bhava. Again count 15 degrees backward, you reach the start of the 12th Bhava. Okay, like this you can go on creating the Bhavas. So you will have the first Bhava, second Bhava, third Bhava, fourth Bhava, and so on, 11th Bhava and 12th Bhava, as shown in the brown font here. So what happens in the Bhava chart? Now if you look at the 11th Rashi, that is the sign of Mithun, you can see two planets there. One is Ketu, which is at 9 degrees, and Jupiter, which is at 27 degrees. Now these are in the 11th Rashi, okay, from Leo. But if you see the degree of Ketu, it is 9 degree, okay. And where is the 11th Bhava starting? The 11th Bhava is starting at 14 degrees in the sign of Mithun or Gemini, whereas Ketu is at 9 degrees. So actually Ketu is not in the 11th Bhava, Ketu is in the 10th Bhava, okay, and Jupiter's degree, if you see, it is 27 degrees, so Jupiter lies in the 11th Bhava, okay. Now look at another example. In this diagram, you can see Mars is at 5 degrees in the house labeled number 9, that is in the sign of Aries or Mesh, okay. Now we know that Aries or Mesh is Mars's own house, alright, and for this particular chart with Leo ascendant, Mars is in the 9th house in the Rashi chart, okay, but Mars is at 5 degrees in the sign of Aries, and if you look at the Bhava chart, Mars lies in the 8th Bhava. Now why is Mars lying in the 8th Bhava? Because the 8th Bhava is starting at 14 degrees in the sign of Pisces, and it is ending at 14 degrees in the sign of Aries or Mesh, okay, and Mars is at 5 degrees in the sign of Aries or Mesh. So he is in the 8th bhava and in the 9th rashi. Now, what is the difference actually? So should we take Mars giving the effects of the 8th house, or should we take Mars giving the effects of the 9th house? So looking at this chart, you will feel that Mars is very powerful, okay, because he is in the 9th house. But it is not so actually. So let us understand the literal meaning of the word bhava. Okay, bhava means the sentiment or the feeling that we carry. Okay, so when Mars is placed in the 9th rashi, but he is in the 8th bhava, it means in the 9th rashi, Mars is carrying the sentiment of the 8th bhava. So now what is the 9th house all about? It is about dharma, it is about good luck. Okay, so when Mars's dasha starts, this person will start experiencing good things. Okay, sudden good luck will come in his life. But what will be the end of this? Will the ending continue to be good? No, the ending will not continue to be good, because Mars is carrying the sentiment of the 8th house into the 9th house, and the 8th house is nothing but misfortunes, obstructions, accidents, inheritance, etc. Okay, so maybe in the Mars's dasha, this person has a very good relationship with his father. Okay, Mars is also exalted, and everyone thinks that this person is doing very well in his life. Okay, but what happens is, now Mars is carrying the sentiment of the 8th house, sorry, the 8th bhava into the 9th rashi. Okay, and the 8th bhava is also about longevity. So this sentiment which Mars is carrying into the 9th rashi, okay, that can impact the health of the father, and maybe something happens to the father and this guy gets a big inheritance from his father. Okay, so from that point of view, he is lucky from one aspect, that he has got a lot of money. Okay, but in the process, he may have also lost his father. Okay, and so what we looked at as good luck has actually transformed into some kind of bad luck in reality. Okay, so the feelings which he had towards his father, maybe the great love which he had for his father, that was destroyed because Mars carried the sentiment of the 8th bhava into the 9th rashi. Okay, so this is the difference between the bhava chart and the rashi chart. Okay, so the planet Mars is still considered to be in the 9th rashi, but he is carrying the sentiment from the 8th bhava into the 9th rashi. Okay, and this is the exact difference between bhava chart and the rashi chart. So if a planet is in the 9th house in the rashi chart, okay, it remains in the 9th house. But if it has moved to the 8th bhava in the bhava chart, what it means is the sentiment or the feeling of the 8th bhava is carried into the 9th house in the rashi chart. Okay, so this bhava chart is also known as bhavchalit chart. Okay, and there are different ways to create the bhavchalit chart. So we have used the bhav madhya method to create the bhavchalit chart. So friends, hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please mark it as liked on YouTube. Feel free to subscribe to my channel Kamath Astrology by clicking the subscribe button if you have not done so earlier, so you will get notified automatically when we add new videos. For any queries, email us at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com. You can also visit our website astroseva.tripod.com for any queries. You can also download my mobile application Kamath Astrology on Google Play Store and reach out to us. So guys, thanks a lot. We'll see you soon shortly with another video. Till then, enjoy your weekend. Take care. Stay home. Stay safe. Bye.